We got our special guest. We got to bring it on. Willie P. Richardson is joining us. Good morning, Willie.
Good morning. How y'all doing?
All right. Man, we are doing good.
Sound like you're having fun up there.
We sure are. And, Willie, I tell you what, man, we've been having fun with you for a while.
Well, I appreciate y'all playing it. I really do. I know y'all goes out all over the country, and there's about 600 or 700 stations playing it. And the whole thing just started off as a joke to start with.
Is that right? So was going to ask you, how did you start out doing this?
Well, I tell you, I've been kind of mischievous all my life. I'm 58 years old, but when I was a little old kid, I stayed down here in Houston, Texas, about 140 miles south of where I is now. I'm up here in Nacogdoches, a little old town in East Texas.
Uh-huh.
And I tell you, it was a rough neighborhood. It was so bad the grocery stores had pictures of missing policemen on the milk cart. You know? But I've came along that a long way from there. There was an old lady that stayed next door to us, and she was probably the stingiest old woman I have ever saw in my life. And I mean, she stayed next door to my auntie. Really, every time my auntie get a new dress, well, this old lady go buy one that cost $2 more. That's the kind of person she was. So I was about 12, and my voice finally changed, got deep enough I could fool with her. So I sent my little cousin over there to watch her one day, and I said, I'm gonna call and fool her chain. So sent him over there, and I called up and told her I was with a telephone company. And I said, we doing a check here in this neighborhood to see how much phone cord people have in the house coming out their phone. And got to remember, this in the days before they had these plug-in phones. Your phone was just permanently attached, you know, had a little old black box, and it wouldn't go nowhere. And she said, well, it looks like I got about 6 feet. You know, that's the way she talked. And I said, well, you got a problem because everybody's supposed to have 9 feet of cord coming out the wall. And I said, the lady next door to you, I just called her, and she got 12 feet. And she said, sure enough, Lord, that made her mad. And I said, well, what we're going to do about it is this. I said, we're going to solve it right now. We don't even have to come out there. We can do it right now. And she asked what to do, and I said, well, drag a chair over there by the wall. And I could hear her dragging that chair. And I said, now, put your feet up against the wall and wrap that cord around your wrist.
Oh, he did it.
And when I count to three, you pull hard as you can, you get your cord back in your house. You know? Well, of course, I count to three, and the line went dead. My cousin started laughing, and she made him rat me out, you know, and I spent the rest of the summer mowing yards to pay for it. But I don't do pranks like that no more.
You don't do anything to hurt people now or to cost them money.
No, nothing dirty or nasty or anything, but I sure been having fun with it. About got my checking account back up to zero, too. I made a little money.
That is really neat. I tell you what, you know, they're really good. And like your Willie, your compact disc there, when Willie Strikes Again is the one we started with. Actually, your second. We still got your first one. Now, where can people get this, Willie?
Well, let me tell you. You know, there was a famous evangelist went on TV years ago and said if he didn't get $1 million pretty soon, the Lord was going to call him home.
That's right.
Well, my bank called me yesterday and told me if I didn't sell a bunch of these CDs and cassettes this week, they was going to call my loan and I wasn't going to have no home. So, it ain't in a lot of stores, but if y'all don't mind, we got two ways that can get them. I got a toll-free number down here in Texas, and y'all keep calling till you get it because it's probably going to be pretty busy all week.
All right.
It's 1-888-218-6464. That's 1-888-218-6464. And I'm going to be answering the phone a lot of today. I'll take your money, you know. And also, we got a web page called the Worldwide Willie page. We done gone international.
Is that right?
And they can just type it in on what you call one of them search engines or whatever you call it, worldwidewillie.com, and it'll get him. Or Willie P. Richardson.
That is great, man. That is great. I love some of that. I like the one-legged basketball player.
Yeah, that was a shoe store right across the street from this office over here in a mall, you know. But you got a second for me to tell you something happened to me?
Oh, sure, yeah.
You know, your life changes as you go through it and everything. And I've always been pretty poor till this thing came along and made, for the first time in my life, made some money. And a couple of things happened. Me and my old lady, Lucretia, as soon as I got some money, of course, we started having problems. That's the way they say people who win the lottery do.
Yeah,
you know?
That's right. Yeah, your family.
She and I have been married for 28 years, and I guess 26 good years out of 28 ain't too bad. But she, I tell you, when I married Lucretia, she was the cutest woman you ever seen. Had this beautiful figure, little old cute, shapely thing, and I swear, man, after we got married, I believe she got a hold of an electric fork. She eats everything in the house. I can hear in the kitchen at night sound like a bunch of wild animals, and then I have to finally put a lock on the refrigerator to keep her out of it. Well, I got this first royalty check, and she said she wanted to go up to Detroit and see her mama and them up there, and I don't care nothing about going up there, so I said, well, you go on. And I said, I'm going to take you down here to Houston Intercontinental Airport and drop you off, and I ain't going in. That place makes me nervous, and I'm going to come back a week from today, and you tell me what time you're going to be staying out here, and I'll come back and pick you up. And I said, tell me what you're going to be wearing. Of course, it'd be hard to miss her anyway, but she said she's going to be wearing a yellow pair of slacks and a yellow top. So sure enough, a week later, I pulled up down at this big airport, all them buses and things going by so fast, scaring me to death. And I saw her up there waving at me. Like I said, you can't miss her. I pulled up there beside her by the curb. She bent over to pick up her suitcase, and two guys climbed in, thought she was a cab. That's pretty large, man.
Yeah. Well, you know, I heard you've been picking on her on several of your phone pranks. You know, you say that she's a little heavy.
She's pretty large. I tell you one other thing. About a week after that, she and I are probably going to have to split up now, but the sad thing about it, she's going to get half the money off this record, you know.
Man, finally got some money, she's going to take half of it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But anyway, we decided to do a little improvements around the house, and I decided to put a bathroom inside, you know. So I went down to the hardware store and talked to the people, and he gave the name of a plumber, and they came out there, and we walled off a little area there, and they installed everything, you know, the sink and all that stuff. And looked real pretty. Well, I was going to try to save a little money and do the painting myself, you know. So I went down to the hardware store and bought what I thought was a gallon, kind of a tan-colored paint. Well, I came on back home. I painted the walls and everything, and it got to looking so good. I thought it'd be nice if all this everything in here just matched. You know, I always wanted to kind of be a decorator. So I went on and painted the lavatory, and then I painted the bathtub, and then I decided to go ahead and paint the commode and the commode seat. And she came in there and looked at it and thought it looked pretty. And we went on to bed and everything, didn't think no more about it. Well, in the middle of the night, she got up, went to the bathroom, you know, and she stayed and stayed and stayed and finally hollered for me to come in there and help her. So I went in there and helped her, and she was what you call permanently attached. Couldn't get up off that thing. And Lord, I pushed on and shoved on and tried to get off of it, and I just couldn't do it. So I went out to pick up, got a screwdriver out to toolbox and came in there and just took the seat and all with her on it off there, you know, and got outside and laid her face down in the back of my pickup and took her down to the emergency room. Well, all them men came running out there with them little green suits on, and they started kind of getting tickled. I said, Lord, don't y'all let this woman see you laughing, you know, and don't let me, and I was about to die laughing, because just before I had pulled off, I had noticed that I had bought a can of this epoxy glue. It was still sitting there in the garage. It's what I painted that whole room with.
Ooh.
And so they rolled on in the emergency room, and I stand there talking to one of them doctors, and I said, Doctor, have you ever in your life seen anything like this? He said, oh, Willie, I've seen thousands of them in here, but this is the first time anybody ever brought one in here framed like this. But we sure have had some problems since we got some money.
Well, Willie, what did you do before you made it?
Well, I did a lot of things. I mowed people's yards down here and things like that. But I was also in the cattle business. You know, everybody in Texas thinks they got to be in the cattle business.
Right.
But man, it got so bad down here. One day I was going to the auction barn, had a trailer full of little old calves, and hoping to make a few dollars out there. And about halfway out the auction barn, it's about 5 miles out there. Well, I had a flat, didn't have no spare with me or nothing, so I just hitchhiked back to town to get a spare. I came back, somebody had stole the trailer and tied the cows to the fence out there. You know, the cows wasn't worth nothing, but the trailer was. You know? So I decided to get out of the cattle business. And a friend of mine have a record company over here in East Texas, been in business for years, and one day I was by his office. I used to pull pranks on him all the time. And he said, Willie, I want you to make a call for me. A friend of mine work at the hospital, and she wants you to call up there and mess with him. There was that call I did that day on that switching them babies. I don't know if you ever played that.
Yeah, we hadn't got that yet, but I have heard that.
Yeah, it's on the first one. I called up there and told him, I called the baby department up there, and I said, told him what my name was. And I said, my daughter just had a baby a few weeks ago, and she ain't here right now, and I'm sitting here looking at this baby, and we black people, and this baby looks like a Mexican. There's a lot of Mexicans over here in East Texas. And I said, I think y'all have done sent the wrong baby home. And she said, well, there ain't no way. You know, that can happen, because when the baby's born, right when it's born, we put a bracelet on the baby's wrist that matches the mama's wrist, you know, and it just can't happen. I said, well, she can't read, you know. So, anyway, kept on messing with that girl, and she got so nervous, she handed the phone off to some other lady, and I asked her if I could bring that baby back, and I said, you know, the main thing I'm worried about is we ain't going to be able to teach it how to speak English, you know. Well, she started laughing, and anyway, they taped that, and we took it up to the hospital, and them doctors and nurses and everybody was just in the flow, and they said, man, y'all might ought to make an album, so we came back down here and cut that first album in 2 or 3 days, and he put it out around East Texas around here, and it got, I ain't lying this time, it got to selling like real fast, selling faster than Garth Brooks or Dog Pound or anybody back then, you know? And, yeah, and we done shot a video on the large bus rider. You probably ain't played that yet either.
No, huh?
Called the bus station and told them that my sister wanted to go to Fort Worth, which is about 200 miles from me, and I said, she done got pretty large, and I was wondering, if she takes up 2 seats, am I going to have to buy 2 tickets for her, you know? And the thing goes on, and finally asked him if you couldn't get her in none of them seats, they could put her up underneath there where they haul that luggage, you know? And we shot, my sister ain't really that big, but we shot a video on that.
Uh-huh.
And I ran an ad in the paper here for a large black female to be in this video, and Lord, you should have seen some of them came down here. They'd call up here, and the first few to call, I was kind of, you know, shy about asking them how much they weighed, and finally I got over that and just said, well, how much you weigh, and if it wasn't more than 350, 400 pounds, but well, we didn't have nothing to talk about. So the one that got the part weighed 420, but one day one of them got out of her car out here and fixing to come in the office, and she was wearing a Malcolm X t-shirt, and a helicopter tried to land on her out there in the parking lot. That's a large woman, now.
That's a big woman.
I'm talking about large.
Oh, man, Willie, well, I tell you what, man, you are funny, and our Big Show listeners all across America are just in love with you.
Well, I'm in love with them, especially if they'll call up here today.
All right, so we'll be answering his own phone. That's 1-888-218-6464.
Yeah, and let me plug one other thing while I'm on
it. All right, go ahead.
Y'all got any like sponsors around that? It wants Willie P to be the exclusive representative. I cut the commercials, do everything to make a dollar. I'm trying to get out of this marriage to this large woman.
I hear you. All right, so I guess they can call that same number if they're call interested
that,
in hiring
and I'm going to be here today, and I'll talk to them, and also check out the worldwidewillie.com page.
All right, Willie.
And y'all send me y'all's pictures. I want to put a tape of y'all on there. I got a bunch of radio people lying about how funny they think I am on there. You know?
Okay, all right, perfect. We can line up for that, right? Yeah. Billy, y'all take care of that. All right, Willie, we'll be hearing more from you right here on The Big Show. Thanks for calling,
buddy. I appreciate
buddy.
Y'all so much.
All right, man.
Bye-bye, Dean.
Bye-bye.